Prolonged rainfall brought on by Friday's tropical wave and an all-weekend upper-level trough resulted in minor surface water flooding and landslippage in various areas on island Sunday, 1st November. According to St. Lucia Meteorological Services, the most precipitation occurred on Saturday, registering 40.3 millimeters at Urinora and 72.3 millimeters at George F. L. Charles airports, according to reports from the various district disaster committees to the National Emergency Management Organization, NEMO. There was flooding in the capital and parts of Labri, Vieuxfort, Denry, Grosselais and Babineau, with the latter experiencing some infrastructural damage. A siltation removal exercise was undertaken at the Mark Bridge on Sunday after some flooding in that area also. Landslides were reported in Louvette, Upper Olean, and the most significant, the Lakai Road in Denry, which was quickly cleared up by the authorities. Ministry of Infrastructure crew also cleared a fallen tree from the Millennium Highway on Sunday. Director of the National Emergency Management Organization, Doreen Gustav, commends the quick response of the Ministry of Infrastructure over the weekend.
As soon as the reports came in and we called the Ministry of Infrastructure, we would get report that it was already cleared. So they were on the ball, assessing the areas and getting rid of any obstruction on the roads. And if there were any homes that were under threat, they were already there, you know, because I guess they too have their own network. So I want to say that they've done a fantastic job in during this heavy rains to ensure that persons are safe and the place is passable as much as possible.
Gustav attributes mitigation exercises at various locations island-wide to the reduced effects of this upper-level trough as compared to previous devastating weather systems. She did, however, indicate that some attention need be given to Denry South.
The flooding in Richfort, the perennial flooding in Denry South, the village, is something that, you know, we really need to work on trying to do some mitigation measures. It happens every time there is heavy rain, and I know the people in the village, they suffer quite a bit due to that, you know, continuous flooding in the area.
Contending with the COVID-19 epidemic during the Atlantic hurricane season, NEMO remains conscious of the potential for a multi-hazard impact at this time. Gustav assures that procedures are in place with district disaster committees for this scenario.
We have prepositioned supplies at the district level, such as PPEs, cleaning supplies. These are placed with the district disaster committees. We have also received a supply of mattresses from the U.S. Embassy, U.S. Southcom. We wrote a proposal to them and we were able to get over 200 mattresses from them. So these mattresses are prepositioned in the event there is a need to open the shelters and persons are impacted also.
Anyone affected by the weekend weather system and is in need of assistance can call NEMO at 452-3802 or 452-2126.